I'm going out and sit down.
Silly test. What the test you are. Really what you need and everything like.
If everyone would please rise. Who gives this woman to be married?
I do.
Please bow your heads. Dear God, we recognize on this occasion that yours is the power to heal and make us whole. From this act of demonstration, love for each other. May Jason and Katie always choose first the highest vision of each other. Here in this band of family and friends, let them commit to a new life, new thoughts, and a happy spirit of acceptance and tolerance. May angels fill their nights and bless their days. May they find joy, peace, and harmony together, guided by your love. May all of us here be a source of happiness in their lives. May their bond be strong and based on truth. May they always know that in you they have strength and support. And may their lives be one of unconditional love. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. We actually have a bit of a surprise now to start this thing out. Jason and Katie had made a request that the first kisses that they received when they entered this world were from their mothers. So at this point, if I ask Diana and Beverly to come to the stage and give them the last kiss they'll receive before they're married. Dearly beloved, honors guests, thank you for coming. Friends and family have come from so far. We're so happy to have you here this evening. Those stairs were tricky, but we're good so far. We're here to join Jason and Kate together in marriage. Our presence here is our commitment to love and support them as they begin their journey together as husband and as wife. Today, two become one. What lies behind you and what lies before you are tiny matters compared to what lies within you. The greatest thing you'll ever learn is to love and be loved in return. Now, I've known Jason for probably 25 years. A good number of these gentlemen here, myself, were terrorizing the streets of Plano for many years together. So I've known him a long time. I'm very proud of him. Katie, I've just come to know in the past couple of months, but I do know that Jason is a lucky guy. Now, we met probably around 5-6 weeks ago, discussing the planning of the marriage and kind of what we would do. And I asked them both to do a homework assignment. I said, I would like you to write the story of when you each met and the thing you love most about each other. Now, this was not a group assignment. We asked them to do it individually, and I hope there was no cheating. And to this point, I think they've not heard each other's responses. So what we're going to do is just kind of go through and read their responses. So let's start with Jason. Katie's my best friend. She really is. What I love about Katie first is how beautiful she always is. She always is caring for others. She is a spectacular mother. I can't imagine my life without her nor McKinley. They both truly brighten my day. I love that Katie is always positive and supportive in whatever I do, especially in my career. I know there's a lot of women who don't accept what I do. That means a lot to me. At the end of the day, I do it for them. We are both have the same interests, for example. We both like the 70s style, food and music. Also, oddly enough, we both told each other if we were to have a boy, we would like to name him Carter. Oh yeah, and I love, lots of O's, Katie's cooking. Ha! How we met. Well, we met about 10, 12 years ago through mutual friends. As the years grew on, our friendship got closer. About 3 years ago, a good friend of mine told me that he thinks Katie likes me. I was like, what? Come to find out, she did. At first, I was afraid of losing her as a friend, so I told her we shouldn't date. A few months go by, and she still was hinting she liked me. I finally thought to myself that maybe this could work. Best decision I ever made. Can't imagine my life without anyone else. When we started dating, I made a bet. I bet her $1 that she would say, I love you first, and she did. I still have that dollar hanging in my room. Boy, I hope that's how she remembered it. And now Katie's. What I love most about Jason is his passion for everything in his life. Whether it's his art, his work, or his love for McKinley, he He gives all that he has into his passions. He loves McKinley more than I could ever hoped any man would, and watching him with her fills my heart so full. He inspires me to be every bit as passionate as he is in all aspects of life. I couldn't have asked for a better partner to walk through this life with, or a better father for our sweet girl. Jason and I met about 13 years ago. Jason said 10 to 12. A group of mutual friends introduced us. In the first several years after meeting, we didn't really talk to each other a whole lot. Even when we were hanging out in a group, we were always dating other people. And I honestly had never thought about him in a romantic kind of way. Through the years, we gradually began talking a little bit more. It wasn't until March 31st of 2011 when Jason asked me to go to a basketball game with him. And he made it known that it was not a date, just friends. Even though we both knew it was a date, it was more than just friends. From that night on, our relationship kept growing. We even had a bet with each other on who would say I love you first. Of course, I lost that bet, but we all know that he fell in love with me first. So good news for Jason is the stories line up pretty closely. Jason and Katie, you are best friends. That's obvious. 13, 10, 12 years together. Keep that. Never lose being friends. Marriage is not about winning. It's about pulling together in the same direction. Share as much of life as possible. Make daily contact, emotionally, mentally, physically, and spiritually. Jason, continue to lead and inspire your family. Your strength will be theirs and vice versa. Love Katie above all else. She is the queen of your heart. She should know and feel that every day. Katie, love and respect Jason. It will give him strength to lead the family. Your support and confidence will help him to achieve your dreams together. This is my wish for the both of you. And now a reading, 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8, by Grandma Arla.
Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. Love's not puffed up. Love does not behave rudely. Love does not seek its own. Love is not provoked. Love thinks nothing. Love does not rejoice in iniquities, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Thank you.
Now, Jason, if you would please repeat after me. I promise to give you the best of myself.
I promise to give you the best of myself.
And to ask.
And to ask.
Of you no more than I can give.
And to you no more than I can give.
Close enough. Close enough.
I will share in your dreams.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
Support you and strive to achieve your goals.
And finally, I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and bad.
With all I have to give.
With all I have to give.
I will remain faithful to our vows.
I will remain faithful to our vows.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
In times of sickness and in health. You are my best friend,
and I will love
and respect you always.
And I
saying, please repeat after me. I promise to give you the best of myself.
I promise to give you the best of myself.
And to ask you of no more than you can give.
And to ask you no more than you can give.
I will share in your dreams.
I will share in your dreams.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
And finally, I promise to love you in good times and in bad.
I promise to love you in good times and in bad.
With all I have to give. I will remain faithful to our vows.
I will remain faithful to our vows.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
In times of sickness and in health.
In times of sickness and in health.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
And I will love and respect you always.
And I will love and respect you always.
The rings, please. For 1,000 years, lovers have exchanged rings as a token of their vows. These simple bands are not of great value in themselves, but are made precious by our wearing of them. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to be bound together. Let these rings also be a sign that love has a substance as well as a soul, a present as well as a past, and that despite its occasional sorrows, love is a circle of happiness, wonder, and delight. Jason, if you would please take the ring and put it on Katie's ring finger. And repeat after me. Just as this circle is without end.
Just as this circle is without end.
My love for you is eternal.
My love for you is eternal.
Just as it is made of indestructible substance.
Just as it is made of indestructible substance.
My commitment to you will never fail. With this ring I take you,
with this ring I take you,
to be my trusted confidant,
with my
to be my trusted confidant,
my trusted confidant, and partner for life.
Katie, if you would now take the ring and put on Jason's ring finger and repeat after me. Just as this circle is without end.
Just as this circle is without end.
My love for you is eternal.
My love for you is eternal.
Just as it is made of indestructible substance.
Just as it is made of indestructible substance.
My commitment to you will never fail.
My commitment to you will never fail.
With this ring I take you to be my trusted confidant.
With this ring I take you to be my trusted confidant.
And partner for life. Ladies and gentlemen, now by authority vested in me by the great state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jason, do we kiss your bride? Oh.
man. My dog.
Huh? What? I mean, when I first started off and I forgot that one thing, that's what screwed me the whole time.
It's good to have a strike like that, though. It's like, wedding party! Wedding party! Wedding party!
Thank you.
Just like them old stars, I see that you've come so far to be right where you are. How old is your soul? Well, I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up. And when you're needing your space to do some navigating, I'll be here patiently waiting to see what you find. Stars, they burn. Some even fall to the earth. We got a lot to learn. God knows we're that I can make. Our differences, they do a lot to teach us how to use the tools and gifts we got. Yeah, we got a lot at stake. And in the end, we're still my friend. At least we didn't intend for us to work. We didn't break, we didn't burn. We had to learn how to bend without the world caving in. I had to learn.
Now we're going to have the mother-son dance.
And so I'm really happy for you guys. Congratulations. I think I heard a car in the red screen.
Here we go.
Okay. Here we go, Billy.
Be quiet.
For love you, Billy.
I'm Billy. I've known Jason since preschool. We've done everything on the moon together. If you can imagine it, we did it. We've driven across the U.S. together. We've gone out of the country together. That'll come later. But it's unsaid how close that two people can actually be. And how me and him have always been, I see that it's not being passed along, but he's given that gift to someone else, and it's Katie. And I couldn't imagine anyone else that's more perfect for Jason than Katie. I'm so happy for you guys.
Me too.
Coming to the island of the country, though. I had to stop the tears, so here we go. Who here has heard about the Cancun story?
Yeah!
Hey! A few of you, okay, well, it's going to get a little dramatic, so get ready. So, Cancun, our senior trip. We book it, we're all at the airport ready to go, all pumped up. Jason, some of his documents don't add up. He's illegal or something. I think he's Mexican. I don't know. But anyways. Anyways. Well, he can't fly an airplane with us, so we don't know if he's coming or not, because obviously we're out of the country, we're out of touch. I have to get pesos to get on a phone. Anyways, we're out partying as seniors do or whatever, and then we get back in our room and sit on our bed in one of our rooms, and then we go out and there's a huge, huge, huge surprise. We didn't even know that he was going to come. It was fantastic. But anyways, the very next day, it had to be the next morning, we go with a bunch of Plano graduates. Across the street, there's a boat
tent.
Well, we get there, we're the last two, and of course they only have one left. I mean, how perfect would it not be if me and Jason get there and there's only one? So, the person's like, hey, you just drive. I mean, neither of us have ever driven motorcycles. So to start it off, we're driving, well, he's driving, I'm on the back. There's a brick wall just to the right. So, we're leaning here on the street, and the brick wall, and then that's where we need to be. He just guns it. Almost hits the brick wall, just swerves at the last minute, and then we're on the street like, whoo, that was a close one. So anyways, we're going down the street, and everyone takes a U-turn. Keep in mind, we have no idea how to drive a motorcycle. So, we're trying to make a U-turn. I'm standing straight out, I have no idea. I honestly don't think Jason had any idea. You just turn the wheel just like you do with the car. You're turning the wheel and it's not turning. A bus is coming. And we just go flat straight inside the bus. Just nail the bus. I mean, there's damage to this moped. It's bad. The moped's still running. So I walk up to it, grab the handles. It floors, I'm like, and then another bus comes and just whacks the moped. Let's just say, I don't know, what do you call them, Mexican police, Mexican cartel, I don't know. But anyways, $1,000 later out of my ATM, we didn't go to jail, and I paid for the damage to the ATM, or the damage to the moped. And then we went swimming and drinking, so that was our Cancun story. But, yeah, great times. But the first time I met Katie, I know you remember, but I just remember, hey, let's go hang out with these two girls or whatever, and the next thing I know, I'm getting my toenails painted. Yeah. This guy has a true heart, and you can't ever ask for anyone better than a friend. Someone that'll fly 1,500 miles to you when I was living up north in New York just to help me actually move back to Texas. And to top it off, a normal, which would take a truck driver, which was my dad, 24 hours, which I was trying to beat that. But it was hard to do with a two-week-old baby flying or driving 1,400 miles across country. It took us, what, 32 hours straight. I think, what did I take, a 15-minute nap? It was ridiculous. And, I mean, you really honestly can't ask for a better friend like that. So, I'm just really happy that he found someone that he can give that gift to someone else now and just get the family that I know is up for. So, I love you.
Okay, I got a long speech plan, but I'm losing my voice, so I'm going to have to cut it short. I just want to start off by saying, Katie, I love you. Jason, I love you. I think you're perfect together, and I think you guys are perfect for McKinley.
Yeah!
What I'd like for you to do then is take Katie's hand in yours. I want you to put your hand on top of hers. Put your hand on top of hers. Now I want you to realize this is the last time you will ever have the upper hand in this relationship. We love you, kiss. Jason, thank you for marrying my sweet daughter, and welcome to the Foster Crazy Clan.